Hello children, once again welcome you to the online session. Okay, now what is the thing which we are going to see? Types of thermometer. Types of thermometer. Yes, so heat is measured by a device called thermometer. So what is that quantity? Temperature. So now we are going to see about the different types of thermometer. So what is the first one we are going to see? Clinical thermometer. What is the first one? Clinical thermometer. Second one is digital thermometer. And the third type is laboratory thermometer. And the last one is maximum minimum thermometer. What is that? Maximum minimum thermometer. So in the next upcoming slides, we'll be explaining one by this to you. One by one to you. So what is the first type of thermometer? Clinical thermometer. So see, this is the clinical thermometer. So this clinical thermometer is used to measure the temperature of human body. What is that? This clinical thermometer is used to measure the temperature of human beings. It is used to measure the temperature of human beings. So, it has readings from 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius. So, what is the reading which it had? 35 to 42. So, why this has been graduated as 35 to 42? Because the normal human temperature is 37. What is that? 37. What is this? See, this has been enlightened here. What is that? 37 degrees Celsius. So it does not go below that. Below that 35, it will not go. So, and one more thing, it will not go beyond 42 also. So this scale has been graduated in 35 to 40 degree, 42 degree Celsius. Okay. So what is the next thing is laboratory thermometer. What is that? Laboratory thermometer, which is used for measuring the temperature in labs. So for example, to measure the temperature of boiling water. To measure the temperature of boiling water. We cannot use that clinical thermometer there. Because what is the boiling temperature of water? Tell me. What is the boiling temperature of water? At which temperature it starts to boil? Yes, very good. 100 degrees Celsius. What is that? 100 degrees Celsius. So, that clinical thermometer is graduated from 35 to 42. 35 to 42. So, it is not suitable for measuring the temperature of water. That is the boiling temperature of water or other liquids. So, see here, what is this called as? See, you are able to see a tube-like structure, yes or no? Are able to see that tube-like structure? See here. Yes, you are able to see, right? What is this? Laboratory thermometer. Laboratory, you are able to see some red color inside this, yes or no? See here. This red color. So what is this? Mercury are filled inside this. What is filled? Mercury is filled inside this. So you are able to see a red color, right? So it shows the temperature. So this thermometer, see here, one more type of thermometer. So what is this? Laboratory thermometer. What is this? Laboratory thermometer. So, but inside this, the mercury color is somewhat silver color. So, you are not able to see in this thermometer. So, you are far away from me, sir. No, so I am not able to show this clearly to you. You will use this. See, you have a red color. What is the thing you have there? See here, you are able to see this red color is right. So, we need to immerse this inside that boiling water. So, when it gets heated, this point also gets heated and the level of mercury rises. And the level of mercury rises here. Okay. So, this laboratory thermometer is graduated from minus 10 degree Celsius to 110 degree Celsius. So how it is graduated? Minus 10 degree Celsius to 110 degree Celsius. Okay. So it is used to find the high temperature. And what is the next thing? Digital thermometer. Now you are able to see this digital thermometer everywhere. Yes or no? So if we go somewhere, they are measuring our temperature, giving us hand sanitizer, and then after measuring our temperature only, they are allowing us to go inside. Yes or no? See here, what is this? Digital thermometer. It is used everywhere now because of this corona, without touching our body. So it does not touch our body. So by keeping this near our forehead, they are able to measure our temperature. So this is also one type of digital thermometer, but this digital thermometer is used for measuring the body temperature, but this must be kept under our tongue. Okay, this must be kept under our tongue to measure the temperature. So it gives digital reading. It gives what is the reading there? Digital reading. But this clinical thermometer and laboratory thermometer, what they have mercury inside. So nowadays this clinical thermometer has been replaced by this digital thermometers, because mercury is harmful to us. Okay, so it gives LED displays on it, and then so it is hazardous to human beings. Mercury is hazardous to human beings. And the next thing is maximum minimum thermometer. What is this? Maximum minimum thermometer. So this maximum minimum thermometer is used to find the temperature of the day. Maximum minimum thermometer is used to find the temperature of the day. See here. So the maximum temperature is measured this side and the minimum temperature is measured on the other side. So when this minimum temperature is measured, the minimum temperature of a day is measured in the morning and evening time, and the maximum temperature is measured during the afternoon. Okay. So what are all the units? Next we are moving into the units of temperature. So temperature is nothing but it is the measure of thermal. What is thermal? Is nothing but heat energy. So we normally call it as degree Celsius, but there are other units like Fahrenheit and then Kelvin. So these are not there in the book, so just note it down. Fahrenheit and then Kelvin. So what are all the degrees which are used to measure temperature? Fahrenheit, Celsius and then Kelvin. Okay, so now we'll see what is the value of it. So these are all not same. As I said you already, we mostly give importance to the Celsius. We use only the Celsius scale. But in some process, they use Fahrenheit and then Kelvin. Doctors, they used to say, no, it is 102 degree Fahrenheit. Yes? So, the Celsius boiling temperature of water is 100 degree Celsius. In Celsius, the boiling temperature of water is 100 degree. And the freezing point is 0 degree Celsius. But in case of Fahrenheit, the freezing point is 32 degree Fahrenheit. The freezing point is 32 degree Fahrenheit and the boiling point is 212 degree Fahrenheit. 212. And then Kelvin. What is that? Kelvin. So 0 degree Celsius is equal to 273 Kelvin. 0 degree Celsius is equal to 273 Kelvin. So next we will see how to convert Celsius to Kelvin and Celsius to Fahrenheit. Okay. See here. Celsius, Fahrenheit and then Kelvin. I said three units you have. Yes. Celsius, Fahrenheit and then Kelvin. So if it is 0 Kelvin. Just listen carefully. If it is 0 Kelvin, in the Fahrenheit the reading is minus 459. It is 459. And in the Celsius it is minus 273 degree Celsius. If it is 0 Kelvin, in Fahrenheit the reading is minus 459. And in Celsius the reading is minus 273. Okay. And then, if the Celsius is 0 degree Celsius, if it is 0 degree Celsius, in Fahrenheit it is 32 degree Fahrenheit, and in Celsius it is 273 Kelvin. I said you right, 0 degree Celsius is equal to 273 Kelvin. And what I said, 37 degree Celsius is the normal human body temperature, but in Fahrenheit it is 98 degree Fahrenheit. 98 degree Fahrenheit. In case of Kelvin it is 310 Kelvin. In case of Kelvin it is 310 Kelvin. And in Celsius, if it is 100 degree Celsius, that is a boiling point of water, it is 100 degree Celsius. And in Fahrenheit it is 212. What is that? 212. And then in case of Kelvin it is 373. What is that? 373. So these are some of the formulas which is used for converting. So for converting Celsius to Fahrenheit, Celsius to Fahrenheit, the formula is 0.8 into Celsius, the given Celsius, plus 32. For converting Fahrenheit to Celsius, so the formula is F minus 32, that is the Fahrenheit, the reading which is given there, minus 32 divided by 1.8. And in case of converting, what is this? Celsius to Kelvin. So Celsius to Kelvin, so we want to give that given degree Celsius plus 273. See here, conversion between Celsius and Fahrenheit. So Celsius, we need to convert that into Fahrenheit now. So they have given 20 degree Celsius. Consider they have given 20 degree Celsius. You need to convert this 20 degree Celsius into Fahrenheit. So multiply that by 1.8 and add it by 32. Multiply by 1.8 and add it by 32. And for converting Fahrenheit to Celsius, consider the given value is that Fahrenheit is 100. So what you have to do there? Minus it by 32 divided by 1.8. Here multiply by 1.8, add by 32. Here divide by 1.8, minus by 32. Just calculate this and see for different temperatures. Okay? And then for converting Kelvin to Celsius. See, when you want to convert the Celsius to Kelvin, add by 273. Add by 273. If you want to convert Kelvin to Celsius, minus 273. Minus 273. See here, for converting Celsius to Kelvin, plus 273. And then Kelvin to Celsius, minus 273. Okay, so children, go through this once again. If you have any doubts, note down your questions and then you may clarify your doubts with me. Okay, so what are all the things which we had seen now? So heat, cold, yes, and then different types of hot and cold objects, and then temperature. What is mean by temperature? What is mean by thermometer? And then different types of thermometers. Yes, what are all they? Yes, first one, clinical, laboratory, digital, and then what is that one more? Maximum, minimum thermometer. And then what we had seen? Converting, scale conversion. What is that? Scale conversion. Yes, for converting Fahrenheit to Celsius, what you have to do? Given Celsius, consider they are given 20 degree Celsius. Want to multiply the 20 degree Celsius into 1.8, then add it by 32. For converting Fahrenheit to Celsius, so given Fahrenheit, consider they have given 100 degree Fahrenheit. So multiply that 100 by 32, divide it by 1.8. And the next thing, for converting Kelvin to Celsius, for converting Kelvin to Celsius plus 273. For converting Celsius to Kelvin, sorry, for converting Celsius to Kelvin plus 273. For converting Kelvin to Celsius, minus 273. Celsius to Kelvin, C to K plus, K to C minus. Celsius to Kelvin plus 273, Kelvin to Celsius minus 273. Okay. So children, I hope you are clear with this. So if you have any doubts, just clarify your doubts with me. go through the lessons again. Thank you for listening.